as a dermatologist, would you rather be seeing patients or would you be doing this, ye dho, nichodo, nikalo, juice banao, fir sar pe lagao? I don't understand. I really don't understand why a country which ruled our country for 300 years, one of the top distributors there was talking highly about a product which had been invented from here, which is the QR678. And so it felt really proud. So it's 15 to 20 weeks. Now in those 15 to 20 weeks, you're going to get 5 sessions. Each session can be either administered at your home itself, or it can be administered in the doctor's clinic, and it will take about 5 minutes to get done. So you need 5 minutes every month.
That's it?
Every month. It's not a pharmaceutical product, and therefore it does not have any known side effects. So therefore, you could pretty much continue the QR every single month until you die or until you don't want to have hair loss.
Hey everyone, and welcome to Pink Villa. I'm your host Nisha Shetty, and today we are going to talk about a very interesting topic. A topic that has been talked about in a few Bollywood movies like Ujra Chaman and Bala. And many Bollywood celebrities have been trying very hard to hide this problem, and they are constantly looking for solutions. Yes, my friends, we are talking about hair fall. And we came across this innovative made in India product that is creating a buzz across the world. And the product is QR678. So let's together know a little more about this innovation from the innovator himself. Please join me in welcoming Senior Cosmetic Surgeon, Director, The Aesthetic Clinics, Dr. Debraj Shaw. Hello, Doctor. Thank you so much for joining us here today. How are you feeling?
Thank you so much for having me here, Nisha. And it's a pleasure to be here with you and the Pink Villa team.
We are absolutely delighted to have you here. First of all, I really want to ask you one question. I have been told you are a practicing doctor, but now you have beautifully and very seamlessly transitioned into becoming an inventor while practicing and seeing your patients. Tell me, how has this transition been?
The problem, I think, with medicine is that the people who are seeing the patients are not necessarily participating in solutions for the problems that they see in patients. So the doctors have the first-hand information of what problems the patients are suffering from. And if we can use science, basic science research, to seamlessly integrate, so sort of what we call a bench-to-bed philosophy, where you invent stuff on the bench, which solves problems for the patients, and then take them to the bed, where they are actually administered to the patients, it leads to a seamless sort of a solution. Now, I think my past experience as an entrepreneur and also my MBA from an Ivy League B school in the US helps this, because in the US, what I saw was that people were not, doctors or scientists were not only happy to be writing papers. They were taking the papers to actually solve the real life solutions, get products and solutions which can actually be administered on patients and therefore solve the problem 360 degrees. I feel very privileged to be in this position where we are able to find a solution to one of the biggest ills which has been plaguing mankind for a long period of time, which is hair loss.
Whether we admit it or not, subconsciously or consciously, hair fall or hair loss does affect our confidence in the long run. And rightly said, it is amazing, since you're a doctor already, you meet your patients, you understand their problems, and I think that makes it even more easier, and that makes it even more outstanding that you yourself are inventing products catering to the problems of your patients. Congratulations on that note. So since you already mentioned you've transitioned into becoming an inventor, tell me, how did you come up with this idea? How did this all start?
You know, the best inventions on the planet occur through some element of serendipity. So we were actually working on a type of cancer treatment. So in my earlier avatar as a consultant at Tata Memorial Hospital, Mumbai, which is one of the premier cancer centers in the country, and also as a researcher at the IIT Mumbai, Indian Institute of Technology, Mumbai, I had the ability or the benefit of having a great animal house where quality research was happening, having the benefit of seeing cancer patients at Tata Memorial who were losing hair, and having the brains of some of the topmost scientists at the IIT Mumbai who were developing product formulations. So I think it's serendipity that I was surrounded by these three types of people which allowed us to find a solution. So we were actually working on a type of cancer therapy, retinoblastoma and neuroblastoma. I'll cut it short. But when we were conducting mice experiments of the same, this is way back, 2007 and 8 that we are speaking about. When we were conducting mice experiments for the same, we saw that this anti-cancer drug, which was being injected around the eyes of the mice, was causing the mice to actually lose hair peripherally. So when we did our research, we realized that the peptide concentration, simply put the protein concentration of this particular skin of the mice, was undergoing some changes. That's where was our eureka moment. And that's where we started realizing that possibly there was something happening locally which was causing hair fall. Until then, the belief in 2007 and 8 was, if you had genetically ordained alopecia, papa ke agar baal jhade, to bacche ke baal jhadne hi hai. So that was the thought process. But clearly, global level pe, even on your body level, if you're losing hair, something needs to change on the local level to actually cause the hair to fall out.
Correct.
So for instance, if the tree has no leaves, then obviously there's some problem with the soil. So something was changing in the strata of the scalp. So when we started realizing the peptide concentration was changing in mice, we put together multiple formulations in 2009, tested them, and then one of them started working really well in causing hair growth. We named this the QR678, the product we are talking about.
I personally have many friends, especially male friends, who are losing their hair, and they have actually thought of undergoing the PRP treatment, and not just PRP, even hair transplant treatment. Would you like to throw some light on how effective is QR678 compared to a PRP or a hair transplant treatment?
So let's start from the basics. Let's talk about hair fall.
Correct.
Let's try and understand how hair falls and what are the problems with hair. So essentially, men, and let's talk about men first and then let's talk about women. Men tend to lose hair in a pattern which is called the male pattern baldness, which is also called androgenetic alopecia. So androgenetic alopecia, as the name suggests, is a chronic disease. Doctors cannot cure chronic disease. Doctors can only control chronic disease. The time to treat hair fall is always yesterday. It's not even today. So from that perspective, you need to start treating hair fall when there is hair. Chara to tab kaam karegi jab ped mein kuch jad honge. Jab jad hi nahi honge, when there are no roots, how will manure work in causing trees and their growth? That's the problem with hair fall. So now hair starts going first from the temples area, then goes to the crown, and then ultimately only a strip of hair at the back, which is the occipital hair, this hair remains. Why? Because hair in the rest of the scalp, except at a strip at the back, have these receptors, the DHT receptors, or the dihydrotestosterone receptors. And these receptors bind the DHT from the body, and on a background of androgenetic alopecia, cause hair fall. How does PRP work? PRP, the system is, you take blood out, you centrifuge it, this gives rise to the platelets. And it gives rise to a growth factor called the platelet-derived growth factor, which is then injected back into the scalp to cause hair growth. My question is very simple. My question is, you've gone to a skin specialist. Skin specialist has said, let's give you vitamin C serum. Will you go home and start making the vitamin C serum from oranges?
No.
So then why are you making growth factors in the clinics using a mixer? You use a centrifuge.
Correct.
But simple.
Yeah.
Using a mixer, why are you using blood? Are you saying today in the 21st century, there is no scientific method of reproducing growth factors in a predictable manner? Har santre mein agar same vitamin C nahi hoti hai, har santra agar alag hota hai, to har insaan ka khoon bhi alag hota hai. How do you know that the platelets in someone's body has enough growth factors for their hair? You know what's the funny part? The funny part is, there has never been a randomized controlled trial which is considered the epitome, or it's considered the most significant type of clinical evidence ever showing that PRP causes hair growth.
Really?
There has never been a randomized controlled trial to prove that. As a dermatologist, would you rather be seeing patients और वुड यू बी डूइंग दिस, ये धो निचोड़ो निकालो जूस बनाओ फिर सर पे लगाओ, आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड, आई रियली डोंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई. सो फ्रॉम दैट पर्सपेक्टिव द क्यू आर कंसिस्ट ऑफ ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स विच आर 6 ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स नॉट वन. दे आर ऑल इन अ सिनर्जिस्टिक मैनर एंड दे आर प्रिपेयर्ड साइंटिफिकली आउटसाइड द बॉडी बाय अ नॉर्मल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस. So you're certain that each bottle contains the same amount of growth factors. So you're removing one more variable. Now let's go to hair transplant. Hair transplant is a surgery. And in my opinion, it's the wrong name for the surgery. Transplant by definition is what comes from someone else.
Yes.
Liver transplant, lung transplant, bone marrow transplant is coming from other sources. Hair transplant is coming from your backside to your front side. You're taking trees out of Shimla and planting them in Madurai, right? How is that a transplant? It's a translocation.
Yes.
Hair translocation surgery. Now, hair translocation, the problem is you have a limited number of hair, right? Ped to utne hi hai.
Correct.
Zyadatar gir rahe hain, kuch piche baki hain. And those piche are the ones you're transplanting all over. Think about this. 100,000 hair on the head on average. Only 20,000 hair must be in this strip. So you're removing 7,000 from these and replacing the 80,000 you lost. Which means 80,000 ped gir gaye the aur aapne 7,000 ped se usko replace kiya. It will give the illusion of fullness without necessarily creating fullness. Now, hair transplants work really well in areas which have a patch of hair loss. Suppose it's a generalized hair thinning like in women or even in some men. It's difficult to do. Why? Because you're removing trees by their roots. You're removing them from Shimla. When you're removing trees with their roots and you're putting them back in Madurai, kuch ped to marenge. 100 ped nikale the, 10 to marenge. Yahan se nikale, yahan pe dale, all this process, kuch to marenge. So this process leads to your hair being in a different location, but net net, the number of trees are going down.
Yes.
They're not increasing. Why then are we not looking at cellular transduction and changes in the hair cycle, which is what transductional or regenerative medicine like the QR678 does, which goes ahead and replenishes the hair and causes the own hair cycle to change so that aapke baal jo jahan the wo bade.
Absolutely, and especially when it comes to India, with everything being so connected to aesthetics and how you look and how you present yourselves, unfortunately, we are also vulnerable that chahe uska patent ho, proof ho, wahan pe data available ho ya na ho, people tend to go to solutions like PRP and hair transplant, which we're not sure it's going to work or not. But now with interviews like these, with talks like these, where we are all making people aware about products like QR678, I think it's going to help a lot of people. So now we spoke about the product. Let me come to something that I've read about you somewhere, that you have been awarded as the Indian of the Year for innovation and your entrepreneurial work. Please tell us, does this award add more responsibilities?
I think, frankly speaking, I don't think I'm anywhere close to being Indian of the Year. Frankly speaking, I think there's a long way to go for us. I was very grateful and privileged that the Indian leadership conclave thought us worthy of awarding us as the Indian of the Year. But really, I mean, there are so many great people doing such wonderful work in India. And we are still trying to find our feet and grow. So from that perspective, I think there's a long way to go. But yes, does it make you proud? Of course, as an army man's son, and the fact that we are army family and India is a tricolor, which is in our hearts. So from that perspective, being called Indian of the Year gives a lot of pressure, and it's a privilege to look up to it. So you always get the feeling, especially when people start using products like the QR678. We just had our UK and EU launches. And one of the Brits called me up and said that we knew Indian pharma, but we didn't know that Indian pharma was also at the helm of such breakthrough products.
Wow.
So I said, you may not be knowing enough. India is doing a lot. You may not be knowing enough, but it still felt nice somewhere that a country which ruled our country for 300 years, one of the top distributors there was talking highly about a product which had been invented from here, which is the QR678. And so it felt really proud.
The fact that the entire world is talking about your product and right now you're just being modest, you definitely need to take a lot of pride for inventing a revolutionary, first of its kind product like you are, 678. So now, coming back to the product, tell us, where is this product available in India? Is it available across the country? Where can we find it?
So what we are calling the QR678 is the umbrella brand, and there are multiple products including nutraceuticals, shampoos, serums that are coming out. So today the distribution is occurring through all the large skin and hair clinics in India. So if you look at the clinic chains, all the large clinic chains, it's available with most of them. So the QR is available all across India. Is it available at every clinic? No. But will it be available in most large cities? Answer is yes. So from that perspective, that's the distribution. The distribution outside India has actually marketing and distribution partners in various countries. And we are in 10 plus countries now. We just had a launch in Germany, Italy and Spain. And we just did a launch in the United Kingdom, which is Britain. And that's how it's being distributed. So is it available at every clinic? No. But is it available at many clinics now and many more than were available even 6 months earlier? Yes. And over a period of time, will it be available all over? Yes, the distribution is being set up.
That is absolutely amazing. So now my next question is, in the beginning, we spoke about the USA patent and the FDA approvals. Tell me, now since we are aware that this product is FDA approved in multiple countries across the globe, how was the entire process? Was it difficult? Was it easy? How was the entire journey of the entire decade of getting these approvals?
Extremely tedious.
Yeah.
Extremely tedious and very, very difficult. Coming out with a medical grade product is very different from coming out with a food supplement. Because a medical grade product is subject to so many checks and balances, it's extremely difficult. We applied for the patent, the US patent in 2013. We got the US patent in 2017. We applied for the Indian patent in 2012. That came in 2019, 7 years later. So from that perspective, all of those things take time. FDA approvals in any country, our FDA approval in Kuwait took 18 months. Now in every country, if you need 18 months of approval, you can very well figure out how much time it takes and how much capital is needed in order to do that.
So doctor, we have already spoken at length of what different kind of problems can this product cater to. However, there's one issue that is prevailing a lot these days. Hair fall caused post-COVID. So does this product help people who are facing hair fall issues after being infected by COVID?
We're seeing a lot of patients with COVID-induced hair fall.
Okay.
And COVID has been a terrible experience for the whole world. Those who have got infected with COVID and have recovered, we've treated at least 1,000 plus patients in the last 6 to 9 months, us at the aesthetic clinics and our colleagues, who have had COVID-related hair fall. Now, COVID-related hair fall leads to a condition called telogen effluvium, which in turn causes hair fall. Simply put, COVID puts so much stress on your body that the body starts thinking ki isse ladte hain pehle, baal to baad mein dekhenge. So that's why the hair starts falling. So the QR works really well in that. And we've just published our latest paper, again in the Journal of Cosmetic Dermatology, which is one of the topmost journals on the planet, on how COVID-related telogen effluvium causing hair fall is treated with the QR678. So this works really well.
That is great news. Now, since we have a QR678, please tell us, once somebody uses the QR678, when can one expect results? And also, more importantly, at what cost?
Okay. So first things first, please understand one very important thing. If someone asked you the cause of hair fall, and you just threw a stone and said hormonal and genetic, you'd be right in about 80% cases of hair fall. Which means 8 out of 10 people are having hormonal hair fall or genetic hair fall or both. If you're having genetic and hormonal hair fall, it's a chronic disease. It cannot be cured. It can only be controlled.
Correct.
So whether we give you medicines, whether we give you the QR, whether we do hair transplant, once a patient, usually a patient for life. There is no cure. So what might happen is, A, the QR comes in, you first take one vial, each vial of the QR is 5 ml, so one ml is used per session.
Okay.
So as a result of which, each vial gives you 5 sessions, each done at 3 weeks interval.
Okay.
Right? So it's 15 weeks of therapy, 15 to 20 weeks. Now in those 15 to 20 weeks, you're going to get 5 sessions. Each session can be either administered at your home itself, or it can be administered in the doctor's clinic, and it will take about 5 minutes to get done. So you need 5 minutes every month.
That's it?
Every month, right? So you administer the QR, you will typically end up seeing hair growth, between the third and the fifth sessions.
All right. Okay.
So you'll start seeing results in 3 to 4 sessions. So 1 to 2 sessions, reduction in hair fall. 3 to 5 sessions, start of hair growth. Once you've seen the hair growth, one vial should be enough for someone like you who's getting a rejuvenation. Hmm. But for someone with advanced hair loss, then you might need 2 vials or so. There are patients of ours who've even taken 3 or 4 vials. This is a plant-based therapy. So there is nothing to prevent you. It's not a medicine in that sense. Okay. It's not a pharmaceutical product. Mm-hmm. And therefore, it does not have any known side effects. So therefore, you could pretty much continue the QR every single month until you die or until you don't want to have hair loss. Mm. Which is far better than using something like the hair transplant, where the donor area is limited and doing a transplant leads to other side effects and is phenomenally expensive as well. Mm. So in general, coming to cost, 5 ml of the vial, the 5 ml vial retails, the MRP is 41,300. Mm. So it's approximately about 8,500 rupees per session. But the cost will vary at different stages because the doctors will charge differently. Mm. But somewhere between 6,000 to 10,000 rupees a session is what it will cost. Mm.
Since you mentioned that, yes, you can do it at home as well. Can you please shed some light and tell us and how can one use a QR678 at home by themselves?
So we are currently being used by patients in more than the 10 countries where we have FDA approval. Hmm. And even if we say the QR is available at 40 main cities in India, India is far larger than the 40 main cities. And distribution will take time to set up. But people are using it at home. People are administering it at home. The reach of the internet is such that people are able to find out about this. And of course, thanks to Pink Villa for having us here. But all these sort of opportunities lead to people becoming more aware.
Yes.
Today, a guy who might be there in a small village in a state in India also can know about the QR because he has a smartphone in his hand.
True.
And this is a self-administration therapy as well. Hmm. So you actually can administer it with a small device called the derma roller at home.
Oh.
So because it can be self-administered in an idiot-proof manner at home, you don't necessarily need to travel to the doctor's clinics. In fact, initially we kept it only for doctor usage.
Hmm.
Then COVID hit us.
Correct.
Hmm. Then in 2020, we realized that our patients who were undergoing treatment even at the aesthetic clinics were not able to travel to the clinics. And even if they were worried about the side effects or the chances of catching COVID when you come to visit a doctor.
Hmm.
So people started using it with the derma roller. And that has been published in a clinical trial as well, which clearly shows home administration works as well as in-clinic therapy. And therefore, there's no real reason to be going to the doctor in that sense.
Now, my next question to you is, what is the future plan for QR678? Will it be available in any other form for all your patients?
See, hair loss is complex.
Hmm.
Hair loss can be genetic. Hair loss can be hormonal. Hair loss can be nutritional. So therefore, we are coming out with our entire hair suite.
Hmm.
Or an entire bunch of hair products. These are all patented. These all have intellectual property. These are all very strong products in the shampoo area, in the serum area, in the nutraceutical area, so for tablets which give nutrients, and then the administration of the therapy. So this is there in the pipeline already. So by February or March, we'll already have the suite ready, which means there will be nutraceutical shampoos, serums, and the other stuff which are available right away. But in 2 years' time, there will possibly be a completely topical solution which can be administered like a hair oil, which can be sprayed on the scalp and lead to hair growth itself without needing it to be administered in any form, without using a derma roller, without going to a doctor. So it becomes like a hair oil. So that entire pipeline is being set up as we speak. And that will be the future as we move forward.
That is outstanding. And that sounds, again, so easy and convenient for everybody to use. So now, since we've spoken at length about the QR678 and also what's in pipeline for QR678 and the entire hair care range and the hair suite in the coming months, tell us, what is the next innovation that you're working on?
Majority of the next innovations are all hair related.
Okay.
But at the aesthetic clinics, we are a team of top class cosmetic surgeons, plastic surgeons, dermatologists, etc., super specialized in different fields. And so therefore, skincare is also a natural progression of what we are doing. In due course of time, we want to have our own skin line of products, but it has to be driven by intellectual property.
True.
It has to be driven by patents. It has to be driven by top research. It cannot be just another moisturizer, just another skin cream. Because that we will not be strong enough to compete with some of the leaders in the market. Sure. So it possibly makes sense to be going through the route of science rather than going through the route of commerce, where some of the larger already established companies are anyways doing a fabulous job.
That is amazing. Once again, congratulations on creating this revolutionary and first of its kind product in this industry, not just in India, but across the globe. Thank you so much for sharing your valuable insights. Thank you so much for shedding a light on this product, your brand new QR678. It was a pleasure to have you here at Pink Villa. Thank you.
Thank you, Nisha. And thank you to the Pink Villa team for having us here. And to all the viewers out there who've been watching us, I am very privileged and very honored to be representing my QR678 team out here at Pink Villa. I am extremely flattered and deeply obliged that they've given us a chance to speak to you all. Despite being into something which is more lifestyle, they think that health hair care is a massive problem, and not having hair can lead to so many other problems. So taking up this public health problem and going ahead and providing solutions to the social problem as well is something which is extremely amazing on the part of the Pink Villa team. We are very grateful and extremely honored to be here with you all and to be here with you, Nisha.
Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you so much for watching this video. This is Nisha Shetty signing off. Take care of yourselves and see you soon.